It's Mayor Ron Anders with the Mayor's Minutes from our March 14th Auburn City Council meeting. We began during the Committee of the Whole last night. City Council made three appointments to the Commercial Development Authority. The City Council reappointed Lee Alice Johnson to her second full term. And then the City Council appointed Paul Willis and Craig Melton to their first full terms. These are four-year terms that will begin in this month, and they'll go through 2027. I do want to thank Johnny Kinsey and John Reese, who served two full terms on the Commercial Development Authority. Thank you for all that you guys did to support our city during the last 8 years. As we got into the regular agenda last night, we recognized our Employee of the Month. This was the first meeting of the month of March, and our Employee of the Month for the month of March is Miss Amy Whitman. I do have a memorandum here that was sent from Latrice Mose, the revenue manager, to Megan McGowan Crouch, city manager, and I'll read a section of this for you. Another of Amy's responsibilities include assisting customers with payment options. Last year, Amy learned about a program administered by the state of Alabama that provides funding to low-income individuals for utility bills. This required research and evaluation prior to presenting an agreement to the Water Works Board for approval. Her work ensured that qualifying citizens were able to request assistance with need. Amy was promoted to the Utility Billing Office Manager in May of 2021, and we recognize Amy as our Employee of the Month for the month of March. Thank you, Amy, for all that you do. The city also recognized a number of our outstanding employees with service awards. For 5 years, Brigida Longino with Inspection Services, Haley Lott Finance, and Jessica Powers Information Technology. 10 years, Rob Rich with our Police Department. And 15 years, Cody Carlson with Fire, James Pisha with Police, and TJ White with Police. Thank each of you for your great job that you do on behalf of the citizens. And the City Council also recognized three members of our staff who are retiring. Lon Harris with Public Works, Paul Register, Public Safety, and Brock Young with Police, who are retiring. And congratulations to each of you, and we hope that you have a great retirement. During the Auburn University communications, I thought it was worth mentioning that last night Olivia Sutherland gave us a report and said that the recent Auburn Dance Marathon, that the students of Auburn University raised $276,000 for the Children's Miracle Network. Congratulations to our outstanding students here at Auburn that we're fortunate and blessed to get to live with on a daily basis. Your efforts are going to mean a lot to different families. And we appreciate your work and your selflessness. Under City Manager's Communications, City Manager announced a couple of board vacancies that will be coming up. One is the Library Board. There will be two vacancies. Those terms begin April of 2023, and they're four-year terms, so they end in 2027. I will say that one of the vacancies is a member of our Library Board who has served one full term, and I believe that individual will be seeking a second full term. And then the Historic Preservation Commission, there are three vacancies. Those terms begin in April of this year, and they are three-year terms, so they go through 2026. If you find yourself interested in either one of these, please go to the city's website and look up how often they meet and what are some of the decisions that they make. And if you feel like that's a fit for you, then certainly fill out an application, and we'll consider your application at a later date. Under the consent agenda last night, the City Council approved a couple of alcohol beverage licenses. The first is with Ithaca Hospitality Partners, doing business as the Hotel of Auburn University and Dixon Conference Center. And this is for special events at the new football complex located at 650 Biggio Drive. And then Stack's Restaurant, doing business as Stack's Pancake Kitchen. The Stack's Restaurant will be located in downtown Auburn at 145 East Magnolia Avenue. And we're very excited about Stack's Pancake Kitchen coming to downtown Auburn and look forward to their imminent opening. Also, the City Council, I read a commendation that's part of our video that you can go to the city's website to see that recognizes Olivia Sutherland for her outstanding work as the Auburn University's SGA Director of City Relations for this past year. I appreciate Olivia and everything that she's done. She's been committed to her job and been great to get to know Olivia, and all the best to you as you move forward. The City Council postponed last night the decision about authorizing traffic calming devices on Fairway Drive. We will consider that next week at the March 21st City Council meeting. Under contracts and agreements, City Council approved a contract with ALDOT for preliminary engineering and construction related to the two dynamic message signs along I-85. City Council approved a contract with the Alabama Power Company to upgrade the lights in the parking lot at the Auburn Softball Complex. City Council approved a contract with Fifth Asset doing business at its debt book. It is a two-year contract renewal for debt management and lease accounting software for our finance department. The City Council approved a contract with Jacobs Engineering Group to authorize professional services agreement to create plan unit development regulations. This is something that the City Council and the Planning Commission and the staff has been looking forward to for a while now. Ultimately, there'll be a number of meetings that will include the public and include different stakeholders, and potentially the City Council will be considering new additional regulations that will involve planned unit developments in the future. City Council approved a contract with MXI Environmental Services for the collection and disposal of household hazardous waste that the city collects during the household hazardous waste events that we conduct twice a year. City Council approved a contract with ProLogic to purchase police vehicle equipment and installation for 12 new police vehicles. And the City Council approved a contract with Ryan Public Safety Solutions for the support and maintenance of our 911 services. Under resolutions last night, the City Council did not approve a new conditional use for property related to the new lawn golf project on East University Drive. That's actually 2601 East University Drive. The developer was asking for a reconsideration of conditional use of the buffering area near DeKalb Street, and ultimately the City Council did not approve that last night. This is Mayor Ron Anders with the Mayor's Minutes.